Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about new topics under which ranking cycle. Today we will discuss about the open feed water heater. Open feed water heater, again the one component of the reheat regenerative ranking cycle. So what is the importance of these heaters in the vapor power cycle? Then we discuss about this one open feed water heater, also known as the direct feed water heater. It is also known as direct contact feed water heater. It is nothing but mixing chamber. In which steam is extracted from turbine section and enter into feed water section, and then enter into the pump. That means this is also known as the single stage regenerative cycle. This is nothing but the cycle belongs to the one of the main parameter of the reheating ranking cycle. Then it is also in this open feedback heater, the steam enter the turbine at boiler pressure and expands isentropically to the intermediate pressure. And then what happens in this case, the steam is taken from the state and go to the feed water, while remaining the steam continue isentropically to the condenser pressure. This steam leaves the condenser as a saturated liquid at the condenser pressure. The condensed water is also called as the feed water, then enter into the isentropic pump. It is compressed to feed water state and rotate to the feed water heater, where it mixes with the steam extracted from the turbine. From this diagram, listen all of these things. What happens in this case? This is the main component is the pump, boiler, turbine, then condenser, again pump one, and again open feed water heater. That means from this diagram we can conclude that some part of the steam is taken and enter into the open feed water heater, and then some part of the steam is condensed into condenser again, and then via pump one again to raise the water from this point to this point. Again, that means the steam is taken from turbine, again the condensate, from condensate you are taken from the water and you have to heat there and then enter into the pump 2 and then send to the boiler section to generate the steam. And the form TS diagram, what happened? Again 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7. That means when the steam is generated in this section, then some part of the heat is taken from turbine and the enter sent to the open feed water is the bleeding section. That's introduced. Then the steam is extracted from turbine and entered into the open feed water. Then from 7 point, it is nothing but the condenser section. Again, the some part of heat is taken from this condenser. Suppose you have to take the 1 kg of the steam is generated, then mkg of steam is entered into open heat water from turbine, and then 1 minus mkg of steam is taken from the condenser section, and you have to go send to the open heat water heater, and then again the repeat the same cycle. This is form TS diagram, and this is the description of the process. Regenerating cycle, the one more thing, that the bleeding section, bleeding topic has been introduced in this section. This is the main important points, and this is nothing but the ideal, this diagram consider as the ideal regenerative ranking cycle with the open feed water heater. Then go to the your energy balance analysis in this equation. What happens, what is the, how much amount of heat is added, how much heat is added and how much amount of heat is rejected, and how much amount of heat is extracted from this section. Therefore, turbine is the center point. From this center point, the heat is taken from turbine and heat is extracted from this one, and heat is rejected to this one. This is the main center for the turbine. When we have to consider the energy balance analysis, we have to how to find out. Listen, the thermal analysis of the open feed water heater. What happens? Q in, there is a heat added. Heat added H5 minus H4. Let's go to the diagram. H5 minus H4. That is the heat addition takes place in this section. Therefore, you have taken H5 minus H4. Then Q out. The how much amount of heat is rejected? Then consider the mass of steam and then you have to enthalpy drop. Then go to S7 minus H1. Then this is S7 minus H1. This section heat rejected by the condenser. This you write down the heat outside the heat 1 minus 7, H7 minus H1. Then turbine work out, turbine pump work input. The turbine work out is H5 minus H6 plus 1 minus 7, H6 minus H7. Again go to this one, H5 minus H6, H5 minus H6. This is the section. And then another section is the H6 minus H7, H6 minus H7. This is the area in which the work output to be obtained from the turbine. Therefore, work turbine. Then work pump 1 minus M, W pump 1 plus W pump 2. Again, the heat input given to this area. This is pump 1 and pump 2. This two pump 2 given the work input given to the cycle. Then where, what is happening here? What is means is W pump equal to V1, P2 minus P1 and W pump 2 equal to V3, P4 minus P4. And this is the energy analysis. And energy balance, assume 1 kg of the working fluid circulated. How much the diagram taken place, the energy in, energy out. Listen, this is the open feed water heater in which what happens, the some sort of the steam is taken from turbine. The process known as the blending enter into the open feed water heater. Then 1 minus m kg of steam taken from condenser, the condensate. And you have to mixing takes place. And then you have to convert the steam is converted to water and saturated liquid that again sent to the this one pump section. And this is the diagram given in this case. Okay. Nothing but m is mass of steam blend divided by the mass of steam circulated. How much amount of mass of cylinders in the cycle? That means from this diagram we can only the discussion of the how much amount of heat is added and how much amount of heat is rejected and how much amount of heat is utilized in the cycle and the work output taken at the turbine and work input given by the pump. This is the main important things is this one. We have only the main important thing is that the bleeding section is added in this cycle to open feed water heater. That is the bleeding, nothing but the how much amount of steam extracted from the turbine, and this is known this one. Then we discuss about we have already discussed about the complete cycle of the feed water heater and how ideal regenerative cycle, and we'll take the one numerical base on this one and go to the numerical section. How to find it? Well, consider steam power plant operating on the ideal regenerative Rankine cycle with one open feed water heater. Steam enters the turbine at 15 megapascal and 600 degrees Celsius, and it's contained in the condenser at a pressure of 10 kilopascal. Some steam leaves the turbine at a pressure of 1.2 megapascal and enters the open feed water heater. Determine the fraction of steam extracted from the turbine and thermal efficiency of the cycle. In the given numerical, in the given problem, what is the DS numerical belongs to again ideal regenerative Rankine cycle and one open feed water heater, because today we are discussing about only open feed water heater. Therefore, the numerical belongs to this one. In this case, what happened? What is the pressure and temperature is given in the turbine? In the turbine section, pressure is 15 megapascal, having a temperature 600 degrees Celsius. That means the superheated steam is generated, and then condense the condenser. That the condenser pressure is given in this case till 10 kilopascal. And some steam is leave the turbine at a pressure of 1.2 megapascal. That means the bleeding section taking place in this region, 1.2 megapascal, and enters the open feed water heater. Again, then steam is extracted from turbine having a pressure 1.2 megapascal and enter into the feed water heater. That means, listen, in this numerical, this is the boiler section in which the heat is added. This is the turbine, the steam is expanded in this case. Then again, this is the pressure having, the when the steam is entered into the turbine at the time, the pressure is 15 megapascal and 600 degrees Celsius temperature. Superheated steam is entered into the turbine, the steam is expanded here, the work output is getting in this case. Then, the some part of steam is extracted from this turbine and sent to the open feed water heater. This is the bleeding process having a pressure 1.2 megapascal. Okay, then go to the last section. The steam is condensed into the condenser section having a pressure 10 kilopascal. The steam is condensed here again, condensed and then converted into the saturated liquid and then sent to the pump having the 10 kilopascal. And by using the pump one, you have to convert having the pressure 1.2 megapascal. And that means whenever the steam is entered into the open feed water heater, that time the pressure is same 1.2 megapascal from getting the steam temperature and from getting the condenser 1.2 megapascal again enter into the pump 2 and again you have to raise the pressure 15 kilomegapascal. From this diagram we conclude that you have to find fraction of steam extracted from the turbine and thermal efficiency of the cycle. That means in the given numerical you have to find out the how much amount of steam is extracted from this to this section, turbine to feed water, open feed water, how much amount of steam is extracted. There is a dynamic fraction you have to find out, and then you have to find out the thermal efficiency of the cycle. Here there are three: pressure is given, temperature is given, and we have to main focus, you have to find dynamic fraction and then you have to find thermal efficiency. Then first of all you have to draw the TS diagram and you have to locate the temperature, saturation curve have to find out, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 1. You know this is the area in the boiler section, this is the bleeding section and this is the condenser section. Then first of all you have to find stage 1, P1, 10 kilopascal, that is the boiler section, saturated liquid. You have to find out the enthalpy, H1 equal to 191.81 kJ/kg. Then you have to find out the specific volume, V1, 0.00101 m³/kg. Then state 2, P2 pressure, 1.2 megapascal. Again, the entropy is same. Therefore, you have to take an as the H2 equal to S1. Then find out the W pump 1 equal to V1. P2 minus P1 equal to 0.00101 m³/kg in bracket complete, and then 1200 minus 10 kilopascal bracket complete, and you have to for unit purpose 1 kilojoule upon divided by 1 kilopascal into meter cube. Then we'll find out the values for all these equations. We'll get the 1.20 kilojoule per kg is the work pump is given. The work input is given to the through pump 1.20 kJ/kg. Then find out the S2. S2 means enthalpy. H1 plus W pump 1. Therefore 191.81 plus 1.2 kJ/kg will get 193.01 kJ/kg. This is the S2 enthalpy 2. Then go to the state 3. What happens? P3 again 1.2 megapascal. Saturated liquid is there. Again you have to find specific volume and enthalpy. V3 equal to 0.00113 m³/kg. And you have to find S3 equal to 798.33 kJ/kg. All these value taken from the steam table. Because without steam table, you cannot solve the numerical. At every time, you have to refer the steam table. You go to the pressure line. P3 1.2. P2 is the 1.2, P1 is the 10 kilopascal, and all the data taken from steam table. Then again the same condition, state 4, P4 equal to 15 megapascal, and S4 equal to S3, that is the entropy is same. Then you have to find a W pump. W pump V3 in bracket P4 minus P3. Again you have to put the values 0.00113 m³/kg in bracket start 15,000 minus 12,000 kilopascal. 1 kilojoule upon 1 kilopascal into meter cube. Then you have to put the value, you will get the value 15.70 kJ/kg. We are getting the work input also 15.70 kJ/kg. Then go to the to find out the H4 values. How to find H4? H4 means S3 plus W work, W pump 2, 798.33 plus 15.70 kilojoule per kg, you will get 814.03 kilojoule per kg. You are getting the H4, and then go to H5. That means from this equation, you have to at every point you have to find out all the values H1 and S1. This is the main target, and then find out the values final efficiency. The HP4 equal to 15 kilo megapascal. Temperature T5 16 degrees Celsius. That is superheated zone. You go to steam table and find out the values from enthalpy and entropy. H5 equal to 3583.1 kilojoule per kg. S5 equal to 6.6796 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. This is the entropy. And then at a point 6, P6 is 1.2 megapascal. Then S equal to S5, that is the entropy is same. Therefore, we are getting the S6 from the steam table, 2860.2 kilojoule per kg. And then you are also getting the temperature T6, 218.4 degrees Celsius. After that, at point 7 is the condenser point, P7, 10 kilopascal. Again, the entropy is same, S5 equal to S7 from the diagram. S5, listen, again the same, S5 equal to S6, S6 equal to S7. This is the entropy, this is the perpendicular to the entropy diagram. Then we have to find out PC1, 10 kilopascal. Then find out SX7 equal to S7 minus SFG. Then put the values 6.6796 minus 0.6492 divided by 7.4996 equal to 0.8041. From this equation, you are getting the dynamics fraction at condenser X7 equal to 0.8041. Then put the find out the value of H7, that the enthalpy at 0.7, enthalpy at point at condenser, HF plus XHFG. Put the values 191.81 plus 0.8041 in bracket 2392.1 will get the S7, then the enthalpy at 0.7, 2115.3 kilojoule per kg. You are getting the S7, then find out the how much amount of mass of steam, find out mass of steam generated, then mass of blending, mass of steam and blending, then m into S6 plus 1 minus m S2 equal to 1 into S3. This equation has been developed from the diagram. From this diagram, you have to find out to develop the equations, and therefore, then also take the help of this diagram also. This is the center point, and the other steam is entering here. From this is the turbine section, the steam taken from the condensate, and the steam is out from this one. This certainly it falls out from this one. This is the center point. And this equation has been developed MS6 plus 1 minus MS2 equal to 1S3. For solving this equation, the M equal to S3 minus S2 divided by S6 minus S2 equal to 798.33 minus 193.01 divided by 2860.2 minus 193.01 will get 0.22 70 kg. You are getting the mass of steam blend. Then find out the efficiency. How to find efficiency? Efficiency follows the 1 minus Q out upon Q in. Then you have to find out the Q in, that means the pump work. Q out means turbine work. Then Q in equal to H5 minus H4 equal to 3583.1 minus 814.03 kg per kg, 2769.1 kg per kg, 2769.1 kg per kg. This is the work. Input is given to the cycle, the QE. Then Q, this obtained at the pump section. And then Q out, nothing but obtained at the turbine section. Therefore, put the formula 1 minus M bracket S7 minus H1 into 1 kg. Therefore, 1 minus 0.2270 into 2115.3 minus 191.81 kg per kg will find out the Q out at the turbine section 1486.9 kg per kg. We are also having the Q in and Q out. Put the values in thermodynamics section. 1 minus Q out upon Q in equal to 1 minus 1486.9 kg per kg divided by 2769.1 kg per kg will get 0.463, or multiply by 100 will get 46.3%. That is, in this numerical, find out the efficiency getting 46.3, and mass of dynamic fraction, that is the mass of that is in this numerical given, the determine the fraction of steam extracted, that is the mass You have to find out the mass of steam. The mass of steam is 0.2270 kg, and efficiency, having efficiency 46.3%. And then go to the another section, the closed feed water heater. We already discussed about open feed water heater. So today we'll discuss the another parameter, the closed feed water heater. What is the closed feed water heater? It's in this section, the shell and tube type heat exchanger is used. Extracted steam condenses on outer side of tubes to carry the feed water. That means in this case, what happened? Like shell and tube type heat exchanger used. And extracted steam condenses outside the tube carrying the feed water. And then there is no direct mixing takes place. There is no direct mixing takes place in this cycle. Direct mixing takes place in the open feed water heater, but there is no direct mixing in the closed feed water heater. Then next point, the steam condenses in closed feed water at the same time the heating of feed water took place from the pump. That is, in this case, what happening? In this case, the extracted steam condenses in closed feed water while the heating the feed water from the pump. And the last point to be discussed, the feed water having temperature is sent to boiler section and condensate getting from feed water heater. Again, the same point is discussing the heated feed water is sent to the boiler and condensate from the feed water heater. And in this closed feed water heater, the two steam can be at a different pressure since the two steam do not mix. That is, there is no direct mixing has been considered here. After that is a diagram showing there are two types of the closed feed water heater. One is the closed feed water heater with the drain pump forward, and then another is the closed feed water with the drain cascade backward. This and all this thing, again, the is the section, the extraction of steam, then feed water enters, and is the condensate, is the pump, and to higher pressure line in this case. And the another case, again the feed water extraction of steam, again the feed water entry and out, and then the condensate, the bottom side is the condensate, and again the steam trap, and to lower the pressure of the condenser. So that means this is a discussion about the closed feed water heater. And then after studying these two parameter, open feed water heater and closed feed water, after at the last we discuss what is the advantages. What are the advantages of and disadvantages of this feed water heater? So we're discussing the advantages and disadvantages of open feed water heater and closed feed water heater. Then first one, in open feed water heater, there is a simple and inexpensive. There is a simple process and inexpensive, not costly in the open feed water heater. But in case of closed feed water heater, what happens? The complex and expensive. Complex and expensive because the internal tubing network is there. Internal tubing network is there. And another point, in case of open feed water heater, more efficient heat transfer due to the direct contact. In this case, direct contact takes place. Therefore, more efficient heat transfer takes place in the open feed water heater. And in case of the closed feed water heater, less efficient since the two steam are not allowed being in direct contact. There is the minimum heat transfer takes place because there is no direct contact in case of the closed feed water heater. The next point, in case of open feed water heater, each feed water requires separate pump. Each feed water requires a separate pump. The separate pump is required in the open feed water heater. But in case of closed feed water heater, one pump can be used for several feed water heater. One pump can be suitable, one pump is useful for several feed water heater in case of the closed feed water heater. And then discuss about the fourth point and last point. Usually only one open feed water is used. That means only one pump is needed for open feed water heater. But in case of closed feed water heater, we have 7 closed feed water are used in large power plants. That means 7 closed feed water heater use in the large power plant. And this is the nothing but the discussion of the comparison of the open feed water heater and closed feed water heater. Then we'll take the another numerical based on the reheat cycle. Consider a steam power plant operating on the idle reheat Rankine cycle. Steam enters the high pressure turbine at 15 MPa and 600 degrees Celsius and is condensed in the condenser at a pressure of 10 kPa. If the moisture content of the steam at the exit of the low pressure turbine is not exceed 10.4% determine, first one, pressure at which the steam should be reheated. Second, thermal efficiency of the cycle. Assume the steam is reheated to the inlet temperature of the high pressure turbine. So in this numerical, what happens in this numerical, the gleam belongs to the reheat Rankine cycle. In this case, what happens? The turbine pressure and temperature is given, and the temperature is 600 degrees, that means the superheated zone is there. Then condenser pressure is given. But in this case, one more condition is given. The moisture content should not be exceed 10.4%. This is the main important. The new portion is given in the numerical and is different from the other numericals. Therefore, we have to find out, determine the pressure at which the steam is reheated. That is, you have to find out the pressure at which reheated takes place. This is the pressure in which reheated takes place. One first one, that is the 4 to 5, the reheating process, you have to determine the P5. First one, then determine thermal efficiency of cycle. That means from the cycle, you have to find the thermal efficiency. 1 minus Q out upon Q in. First of all, you have to draw the TS diagram. You have to locate the saturation curve. You have to locate the pressure line, the boiler pressure line, the condenser pressure line, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 1. That is the 3 to 4 and 4 to 5 and 5 to 6. That was 3 to 4 turbine section, 4 to 5 reheating section, and 5 to 6 the condenser section. Okay. And therefore, you have to draw the diagram. And what is the input required, input given in the numerical, and what is the output to be find out. In this case, first order draw boiler, pump, it consists of pump, boiler, again the high pressure turbine, low pressure turbine, condenser, and reheater. First of all, the steam is generated in the boiler and enter into the high pressure turbine, and some steam is entered into the again boiler to give the heat to the water to generate the steam, and then again come back to the low pressure turbine, and then come into the condenser section, condenser to again go to the boiler section. In this case, at the entry of the steam entry in the high pressure turbine at the 15 megapascal, and then enter and having a pressure enter into the condenser 10 kilopascal, and then again leaving the condenser again 10 kilopascal, you have to determine the reheating pressure P5 and thermal efficiency. The first of all, use the steam table, and then you have to proceed. The first one, the reheat pressure is determined from the requirement that the entropy at the state 5 and 6 are same. Again, go to the TS diagram. 5 to 6, that is the S5 equal to S6, S3 equal to S4, S2 equal to S1. And these are the entropy is same from the TS diagram. You have to point at the point 6, P6 equal to 10 kilopascal. You are getting the X6 equal to 0.896 such a mixture. Then you have determined the S6, there's enthalpy at 0.6, SF plus X6 SFG. You have to put the values 0.6492 plus 0.8936 into 7.496 will get 7.3688 kg per kg Kelvin. This is the entropy at 6. Then find out the S6 enthalpy at 0.6. S6 equal to SF plus X3 S6 HFG. 191.81 plus 0.896 into 2335.1 kg per kg. In this case, the value is given. SFG, HFG, all these were taken from the steam table having a pressure. Then go to the state 5. That the P5 pressure is the then after that P5 T5 600 degrees and S5 equal to S6 from the steam table and Mollier chart, you are getting the P5 equal to 4 megapascal and H5 equal to 3674.9 kg. Therefore, the steam should be reheated at pressure of 4 megapascal or lower to the percent as moisture content above the 10.4%. Then determine the efficiency of that one. How to find efficiency? You need the enthalpy of the other all states. You have to find out the enthalpy at 0.1, enthalpy at 0.2, P1 equal to 10 kilopascal saturated liquid. Then you have to go to steam table, find out the values. H1 equal to 191.81 kg per kg, and find out the specific volume. V1 equal to 0.00101 km³. Per kg. Then go to state 2, P2 equal to 15 megapascal. Then find S2 equal to S1. Again go to this line, 1 to 2 line, and your discussion is here. Then find out the values find out the values of this one. State 2 P2 15 megapascal, S2 equal to S1, the entropy is same. Then pump work V1 P2 minus P1, we will get the value 15.14 kg per second. After that, we have to find out the S2, S2 equal to H1 plus W pump, put the values 191, 181 plus 15.14 kg per kg, we will get 206.95 kg per kg, we are getting the enthalpy at 0.2. Then state 3, state 4. As per the pressure given, P3 equal to 15 megapascal and T3 is 600 degrees Celsius. That you go to this again, the steam table, you have to find out what is superheated stone. S3, we are getting S3 values, we are getting S3 values. At find 4, we will get finding out the P4, 4 megapascal reheating section, S4 equal to S3, and we will get the H4 equal to 3155 kg, we are getting the temperature T4 equal to 375.5 degrees Celsius. After that, we are getting all the values, you find out the Q in, Q out. Q in equal to S3 minus S2. Again, go to the TS diagram, S3 minus S2. S3 minus S2. This is one. And second is the H5 minus H4. H5 minus H4, and this is the section, okay. And from this, we have found out the value of Q in the heat is added, then we'll get the values 3896.1 kg per kg. After that, you have to find the Q, the bomb work, and the Q out S6 minus S1. S6 minus we again go to TS, S6 minus S1. This is S6 minus S1. This section, the condenser section, formula section, we'll be finding out the put the values. 2335.1 minus 191.81 kg per kg, will getting the value Q out 2143.3 kg per kg. Then find out the efficiency of that one, again thermal efficiency 1 minus Q out upon Q in, put the values. Finally, will get the 0.45 multiplied by 100, which is the 45% efficiency. That means in this numerical, we have to determine the reheating pressure. You have to reheating pressure and find the efficiency. The reheating pressure is giving finding out 4 megapascal and having efficiency 45.5 or 45%, and this is the end of the today's session.